Yeah!
Listen up, partners. This is Good, Bad, Ugly on World Improv Network.
Hello, y'all. This is Alex.
Hey, this is Asa.
I'm Jim.
And we are your astute win counselors for the week to give you advice on any of your daily problems or weekly dilemmas. So what we're doing right now is we're going to grab a suggestion of a problem that was given to us by one of our, you know, winners, one of our win contributors. And it comes from Skeeter from Tallahassee. He asks, "Dear Win, I am physically attracted to playground equipment. What should I do about this?" Asa?
I would say the best thing you can do, I mean, if it seems like, I guess the problem is that it's a hindrance to go, like, go for walks and just be out and about the town and to run into some playground equipment.
Which, think there's magnetism going on there? Is like physically getting drawn to the equipment, or you think you just cannot stop looking at it?
I think it's just a personal preference, kind of not a persuasion, but a fixation.
Yeah, fixation, yeah. So what do you think?
I would say get yourself a playground set to install in your own backyard, or maybe get one of those like Fisher-Price sets in your basement if you want to have some private time with this equipment. But otherwise, I would say, when you see that there's playground equipment and you don't want to get involved with it, just turn around, just don't go there, because other people want to use that equipment and it could lead to some really bad, embarrassing situations.
Okay, that is an incredible investment if you're going to start installing a playground in your backyard. Look, Winner, I understand not everybody has the time or the money to be able to do that. So you got to use the playground equipment that's available. But you can't, you got to go at midnight or, the least populated times. You have to moderate yourself to be there when you're going to get, when you can enjoy it all by your lonesome and not enforce your beliefs on anybody else.
Well, that's quite interesting, Jim. But you're still talking about him changing his lifestyle. And if he's going to change his lifestyle, Skeeter, Winner, if you're going to change your lifestyle, I think the real thing to do is, why don't you just get a job at Toys R Us? Quit your job, whatever the hell you're doing. Go to Toys R Us, work 80 hours a week, and you can be around all the Fisher-Price playpens playground equipment you could possibly imagine. As a matter of fact, offer to sleep there. Why don't you just bring a bedroll and sleep in the back, so when all the employees leave, you can sit there for the next 8 hours before the store opens up again and get to play all you want and have all the fascinations and fixations that you can handle on a daily basis, to the point where you almost get neurological overload, and then maybe you don't want to do it again for another 12 hours.
Okay, if you want to have a job, sure, go ahead and do that. But, I mean, who wants to have a job?
Well, that's a good point, too. Maybe he should just quit, go on unemployment, and just live at a playground.
Ooh, I like that one. I think you should go with Alex's advice there, caller.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. Well, the next one comes from a man called Roy Fellows, and he is from Indiana. Roy seems to have a problem that, he thinks that wherever he goes, that he has to be the alpha male. It gets him in a lot of fights. Huh. Jim, you seem like you're savvy with the boxing gloves. What do you think about that one?
Well, if you're going to take that attitude out into the world, eventually it's going to get you into trouble. So you have to learn some self-control. So I would enroll in martial arts classes and learn some discipline. Because the martial arts, they're not for fighting. They're about self-discipline, about controlling yourself. So, Roy Fellows. I think you should go take some Taekwondo or Kung Fu classes.
I would have to disagree with that one, Jim, because here's the problem. If he doesn't get the discipline, he's just going to get more of a, tough guy attitude. So I think you should actually take as much martial arts as possible, not for discipline, but to try to become the toughest alpha male around. And so when he comes across somebody, he just beats them all up. And at the end of the day, there's no one left to fight. And if there's no one left to fight, you don't have the urge to be an alpha male because you don't have no reason to be defensive. That's clearly the answer here.
I don't know. I feel like there's a way to avoid fights while still asserting oneself as an alpha male, and that is bring a PA system with you wherever you go and just announce it. Just by saying that you're the alpha male, other people will be dissuaded from any kind of interaction. And I don't know, that's a pretty easy way. Just assert yourself audibly versus physically.
I mean, at what decibel level are you thinking, Asa? I mean, how high does he have to be asserting himself?
I don't know, is 50 decibels, is that loud?
I don't know. I think rock concerts are like 120 or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's not loud now.
Okay, so like 150.
Okay.
150, yeah. Well, if that's humanly possible, then yeah, maybe that would work. Otherwise, I'd have to say go with mine or Jim's suggestion.
Yeah, I would just, I think just getting into martial arts in general is a good suggestion for anybody.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Matter of fact, last week, you know, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Putin, President Putin, said he was a martial artist himself, and clearly that's shown a lot of discipline. So, yeah, maybe that is the way to go.
Yeah, all yeah right. When in doubt, follow Putin.
Okay. Well, we got one more here. We got another one of our win contributors, Garth, who loves and is addicted to nutmeg. Garth, addicted to nutmeg. Well, I don't know really what the biochemistry is there and what's causing that addiction, but I would say that maybe you should eat a lot of Nutella, because I think Nutella might have some nutmeg in it. And if not Nutella, just go out and order any kind of food at a restaurant that has specifically nutmeg. And they say, look, do you have nutmeg on this tacos, or do you have nutmeg in your Caesar salad? And if they say no, then demand it or leave the restaurant, because you got to feed that addiction from day to day. I mean, that has to be the way.
Yeah, I would say bring a water bottle with you, like a Nalgene, something that can carry up to a liter. And actually bring a few of them, like have a backpack full of it, and just so you're never without.
Hmm.
You know, you can't blame other people for not having nutmeg.
Hmm.
Just bring your own.
Okay, I hate to call you guys on this, but neither one of you are helping Garth with his problem. Like, you're still keeping him on the nutmeg. That's going to hurt him in the long run, too much of anything. Garth, what you need to do is you need to get addicted to something else as soon as humanly possible. So before that nutmeg wreaks havoc on your digestive system.
Hmm.
Heroin, very easy to get addicted to. Cocaine, the same. Pick up any of those. Methamphetamine, that's the one. If you want to get in, also if you don't like your teeth, a bonus.
Or hentai.
That's
another easy addiction.
Yes.
Right. Well, yeah. Maybe how about like World of Warcraft or something? Maybe get him addicted to a video game, so then therefore he just kind of anti-socializes.
World of Warcraft is going to give him carpal tunnel. So we don't want to exchange one problem for another.
That's true.
We just need to get him off that nutmeg addiction.
Yeah. And there's really no benefit to teeth, so maybe that is the way to go.
Right on.
Yeah.
Okay. So I think we're all in agreement, caller. Go out and get addicted to meth.
Okay, fantastic. Well, that's going to conclude our Good, Bad, Ugly segment today. We are, again, your astute win counselors, Alex.
Asa.
Jim.
Yeah, and now stay tuned for a final piece of inspiration to guide you through the rest of the week.
Love, fortune, status. Let us do your astrological chart. Horoscope Corner on World Improv Network.
Yeah, okay. Today's astrological sign is Scorpio. And here, for all you Scorpios out there, we know you're determined. We know you're loyal. Matter of fact, we know you have a very high sex drive as well. But therefore, don't look at life that way. Look at life as a complete ruckus. It's just a complete hodgepodge of craziness, and embrace it. Once you're able to embrace this craziness, this ruckus, this madness that runs around the world, all around you, you will be happy. And everything else that makes you a Scorpio will make you grounded and make you sane. That is our reading for the week.